How many of you guys have dogs? Do your dogs ever run away, go outside? No? Well, you're going to learn about what happens to those dogs that run away. Before I start, I want to give you guys a trigger warning. There might be some images that might be unsettling to some of you, so hold your eyes if you're down. Okay. So, every day, dogs go missing. And it's only dogs that are strays, that are outside, that run away from home. They get picked up by random people. But they're not that random. These people who pick them up are people who set up dog fights. They pick them up so they can use them as bait, which I will explain later. So they take these poor little innocent dogs, and they throw them into a ring, where they have to fight for their lives, all for human enjoyment, all for our enjoyment. That's it. So, when I was 16, I went to Mexico. And in Mexico, fighting dogs is illegal now, but it used to be legal in 2015. And next to my house, there's this old little place that always had dogs, but I never knew what it was for. And one day, I was sitting outside with my grandpa, and all of a sudden, two of these dogs yelped, like, barking, and just running outside really fast, and they're fighting, and they have blood all over them. And I'm scared to death, because I don't know what's happening. And then I learned that it was a dog fighting ring. And it was really sad, and ever since, I haven't been able to get that image out of my mind. So, although animal fighting is illegal in the United States and many other countries, it still happens underground. It still happens in Arizona, in California, and various other states. And something that we need to do about it is raise awareness and teach people about it. So first, I will describe what animal fighting is. Then, I'm going to teach you about the effects on animals and what we can do to stop it. So, animal fighting is a gruesome activity for animal lives that we set up to fight in a little ring, but it also indulges in other kinds. There are many types of animal fighting, but today the most common: dog fighting, hog and dog fighting, and rooster fighting. First, I will be talking about dog fighting. So, dogs are thrown into a little pit, 20 by 14 feet, and these dogs are usually bred or just found on the street, as I said before, and thrown in here, according to the animal fighting stats by animal legal authorities. And, yeah, they just throw them in there to fight. Sorry. Then there's also rooster fighting. Rooster fighting is a little different than dog fighting because roosters are bred specifically to fight, and they have a gene that's very aggressive, according to the ASPCA. When thrown into fighting, they have a little razor that's attached to their leg, so when they fight, they can actually hit each other. And before they start fighting, the two owners will get the two roosters and kind of egg them on to each other, so they will start fighting. Then we have hog and dog fighting, which is a little different than the rest. So first you have a hog, which is kind of like Timon from Lion King, if you remember that movie. And then they throw the member with two other dogs or one dog. And they have to fight it out. Usually the dog is end up losing because the hog is much, much stronger. And so you can imagine how that goes, according to the people. But in these instances, there's always other crimes involved. There's gambling, there's drug use, and there's weapons. So, usually, if a fight goes wrong, there's going to be weapons pulled out, there's going to be shots fired. In Arizona, in 2007, there was an incident where three people were killed because of a cockfight went wrong, according to the animal fighting stats. So, first I'm going to be talking about how the dogs are treated. Of course, there's three types of animal fighting, but I'm going to talk about the most common, and everyone here has dogs, so it might resonate with you. So, you may wonder, how do these dogs end up at these fighting rings? First, the people go to shelters. They adopt dogs that no one else wants, but they usually go for dogs that are really big and strong, or if they're not looking for a fighting dog, they'll look for a dog that they can use as a bait. But they also look for cats if they want to use it as a bait. And if they steal a dog, it's most likely going to be used as a bait. treat dogs because most dogs on the street are really skinny and perfect for baiting. Additionally, they're used as, they also breed the dogs and they keep them in little kennels as such. And they get dogs specifically pit bulls, or they cross-breed them with other dogs that are also very aggressive. So this is all according to Dog Tips and Animal Exploits. So how are these dogs trained, may I ask? So first, they put them on little treadmills like this. And they're set to run. And in front of them, okay, right here, they're usually a little big dog. So it's a little tiny dog, like a chihuahua or a cat. And they will run after that animal. And at the end of their training, they get that animal's reward. They get it heated, they just destroy it like a little. They also get locked up in heavy chains. They use these heavy chains to make them stronger in their upper chest. So, and then they will also put them really close to each other, but not close enough where they can fight, but close enough where they will pull each other a lot and want to fight each other. So that's according to how fighting dogs are trained to perform reality. And then another thing that they do is they put drugs into these dogs. These drugs will eliminate pain and they will increase muscle mass. Another thing that they will do is starve them. By starving them, it creates more aggression in them. And if these dogs don't want to fight, they're either killed or they become bait animals. Bait animals are just dogs that are used as a toy for the aggressive dogs. So they just throw them in there and they can have their little fun and kill them basically. And if they don't fight, they're either shot, strangled to death, or drowned. A really famous case that happened in 2007 was this NFL player, Michael Vick. So according to LA Times, this case was very public, and everyone knew about it at the time because he's an NFL player. But he got caught because there was someone who went into his house because of drugs, but the police saw that there was a lot of dogs chained up. So they got a warrant and went into his house, and what did they find? They found a lot of dogs that were being used for fighting purposes. Here you can see that this is one of the dogs that were in his house, and they would fight them, and when he was in court, he would say, he had team members going on his side, and it was okay that he could do them. He was actually signed up as a breeder, so he would own these dogs. This is all according to the MLB. In the case, they stated that if they didn't perform well, these dogs, he killed 8 of them. And they were killed by hanging, drowning, or slamming them to the ground. Additionally, the police found that there was 56 dogs in this house. 54, actually, sorry. And they were all under them. So imagine that. So you might be wondering, what can we do to help? What we can do is raise awareness, as I'm doing right now. I'm teaching you guys about this, what you can do, where the signs to look for as they're chained up, are there scars on them, that's what you can do. Additionally, rescuing is not enough. So you might think, okay, we can just rescue these dogs. No, it's not enough. Most of these dogs that are rescued are put down because they're too aggressive that they can't do it into a home or people can't adopt them because they will start a fight. And if you're suspicious of something happening, you can call authorities, call 911, tell them what you're seeing. See a dog that's malnourished in the house, if you see that 50 dogs being chained in a big farm or something, it's probably being used for a lot. So, you can come together and you can start a process of trying to take action to stop fighting, to stop fighting. You can come together and start a process quite often, or you can just teach others, as I was saying before. Oh, and you can also donate to the Humane Society of the United States. And you can donate some money, like either once or monthly. In conclusion, animal fighting is the issue all over the world. It's illegal here, but it's still legal in many other countries, and it still happens here, even though it's illegal. And if you have a dog, how would you feel if it ran away?